Hi, this is Naomi with topshelfva.com. This tutorial will demonstrate how to create custom-shaped PNG assets in PowerPoint, other than your normal square or rectangle, and filled with a photo using the Drawing Shapes and Crop tool, and saving the asset to use in Camtasia or other video editing software, or simply as an image with a transparent background to use elsewhere. I have another video demonstrating the same effect using Photoshop, which is linked below. If you have PowerPoint 2016, click here to skip to go directly to the instructions for creating a custom-shaped, photo-filled PNG asset. Yes, I'll be upgrading to Office 365 over my summer vacation. If you are in PowerPoint 2010, you will have to adjust the slide size to a 16:9 ratio. If you have PowerPoint 2016, the default should already be sized as 16:9 ratio. If you have PowerPoint 2010, let's first change the layout to a blank layout. Then click on the Design tab. Click on the Page Layout and then click on the Slides Sized for the drop-down menu and select On-Screen Show 16:9. Click on OK. Now you may see that your horizontal guideline has disappeared. An easy way to get this back is to click on the View tab. Click on Grid Lines and you'll see a slight empty horizontal space in the grid area around the horizontal zero center. Hold your left mouse key down until you see it says zero and move the line up a little away from the center. You can then uncheck the guidelines and then go back and move the horizontal guideline back to zero. This way you have your guidelines set so you know where dead center is of the 16:9 ratio slide. Click back on the Home tab. Click on the Oval Drawing tool to select it. Move your cursor down until we are right over the center guidelines, and while holding down your left mouse key, also hold down the Control and Shift keys. Then move the cursor out to create a perfect circle from the center of the slide. Click on the Drawing Tools Format tab. Click on the drop-down button for the shape fill and select Picture. Find the picture you would like to fill the shape with. You'll see it fills the shape, however, it squeezes everything out of proportion to fill the object. What we now want to do to set the picture back to its proper ratio is to click on the Picture Tools Format tab. Then click on the Crop drop-down menu and select Fill. The picture now resizes to its original size with what will be seen inside the shape fully visible and everything that falls outside of the shape grayed out. You can now move the picture to where you want within the shape. You can also expand the picture by putting your cursor on one of the corners, holding your left mouse key down, and also holding down your Shift and Control key to adjust the size. Once you are satisfied with how it is lined up within the circle, simply click outside of the picture area. Now if you want, you can change the border by clicking on the picture, then clicking on the Drawing Tools tab, then going to Shape Outline and selecting the color you want for the border. If you want to change the thickness of the border, click on Shape Outline again and click on More Lines. By clicking on More Lines, you can choose any size larger than 6 points. Simply click on the Up arrow key to adjust the size or type in the number you want. Then click on Close. To save this as a PNG, which gives the transparent background to the image, right-click on the image and select Save as Picture. The default should be PNG. If it is not, select it from the Save as Type drop-down menu. Go to where you want to save the image. Name the file. We'll call this PowerPoint Machu Picchu Sample 1. Then click on Save. Now you would do the same thing if it was a different shape. Let's add a new slide by clicking on the New Slide button. Then we'll go to the Drawing Tools and pick a really odd shape this time. Put your cursor in the center, holding your left mouse key down and then your Shift and Control key, move your cursor out from the center. Once you have done that, click on the Drawing Tools tab, Shape Fill drop-down, and Picture. Then select the picture you want to fill it with. To adjust the picture ratio size, click on Picture Tools and then the Crop Tool drop-down button. Select Fill and then adjust as appropriate. Now if you want, you can change the border by clicking on the picture, then clicking on the Drawing Tools tab, then going to Shape Outline and selecting the color you want for the border. If you want to change the thickness of the border, click on Shape Outline again and click on More Lines, and adjust the width to what you want. Right-click on the image, Save as Picture, and Save as PNG, giving it another name. What if you wanted to to change the image that was inside of a shape. It's quite simple. Click on the image to select it, click on the Drawings Tools tab, click on the Shape Fill drop-down menu, choose a different picture, then the Crop Down menu, and select Fill. Adjust the image as appropriate, then save the image as a PNG. That is how you can create images for your Camtasia callouts. You can now import those images into Camtasia and use them, resizing as needed without losing the quality of the image. Now make sure to subscribe to the channel for more tips and tricks on using Photoshop, Camtasia, PowerPoint, YouTube, and tips on being a small business owner, or 60-second tips on just about anything. And of course, my fun It's Friday videos to brighten your day. If you're an eclectic person like me and like to know a little bit about everything, then this is the place for you, so make sure to subscribe. Oh, and also don't forget to leave a comment below and let me know if this was helpful for you. This is Naomi with TopShelfVA.com. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.